The following feature has been rated PG by the Motion Picture Association of America. Parental discretion is advised.
It's party time. Oh, it's party time. Having a party. Come on.
Live from Pacific Quay, it's another quality broadcast from the BBC.
It's Friday, 20th of October. If there's no pictures in it, I'm not reading it.
Don't tell everybody you know, it's the Ashley Storrie Show. Tell everybody you know, it's the Ashley Storrie Show. Come for the music and stay for the sparkling wit. Silent boys, ladies, all right, let's get on with it. Go tell everybody you know, it's the Ashley Storrie Show.
I'm Ashley Storrie. You're listening to BBC Radio Scotland live from Pacific Quay, joined as always by sidekick Silent Paul. This week we're talking books. Paul, how are you this week?
I'm all right.
We're talking books. It's a battering weather out there. Everybody, get inside, cozy up with a good book. Paul, what's your favourite book of all time?
That's a tough one. I'd need to have a think about it because I have different books from different times.
Tell
in
me
your
different.
Life.
So just give me a spattering.
Well, like, you grow up, so when you have your like your teens and your early 20s books,
okay,
that you then read like, oh, I'm gonna read Kurt Vonnegut books,
yeah,
and
yeah,
think
yeah.
That I'm really like edgy and stuff, uh-huh, like that. But like before that, your favourite book was probably like the Turning Adventure books, where you go to page 26,
pick your own adventure
go,
books.
Nope, go back, go
yes.
back.
Edit under.
Always cheat. Always cheat. Did you see that they did, like Bear Grylls did a Netflix special? Other streaming services are available. Other adventurists who may or may not stay in five-star hotels are available.
Yeah.
But he did one where it was exactly the same, where you press a button and you can say, oh, I'm at the river. Shall I jump over the river or shall I try and find a crossing later
on? I never understood that. I remember watching Bear Grylls and he was like, how to survive if you land on a frozen mountain with a rope and a tarp. I'm like, where am I getting a rope and a tarp from when I fall out of an aeroplane onto a frozen mountain?
Also, he does things, but he's just like, now just tie this knot. And he's like, I'm dead. That's me. I'm done.
I've already slid on a muddy patch, broke my leg and have no idea how to splint it. I'm not even getting to the bit where I eat like a bug. I'm not there, Bear Grylls.
No.
It's not. I prefer, and it's controversial, Rémy's. Rémy's was a more approachable survivalist.
Just like, just cook up these nettles.
Yeah, he was just like, squat by a campfire in my Boy Scout shorts and then I'll cook up.
Just spent like 4 hours just walking about going, can you eat it or not eat it? And be like, yep.
And
no.
See, that's what you need. You don't need some Bear Grylls naked frolicking in the snow. You just need a big guy in shorts who can tell you what you can eat and what you can't eat. That's
exactly
how you
that's all I want in life.
So therefore,
anyway,
Rémy's, better survivalist.
Ashley, what is some of your favourite books? Obviously, we know your love of the Potterverse.
Yes. Put that aside, right?
Mm-hmm.
That's a whole other thing. That's autism.
Yeah.
Discworld, anything Terry Pratchett. Love a bit of Pratchett. Love a Bill Bryson book. Love learning facts via Bill Bryson. Love his book A Walk in the Woods. Made me want to walk the Appalachian Trail, even though I
hate
walking.
Read a Bill Bryson book.
I find him really fun and really engaging, and I like sort of books that it's easy to engage with the author, and I think he's really good at that. Then there's just like the weird books that I've read that I don't know why that I read when I was a child. Like, when I have no idea, A, how I got them, and B, why I read them. I read The Horse Whisperer when I was 11. I don't know why. There was a dirty bit in it. I think that's why I read it.
Because like
I got told by an older girl, there's a dirty bit in The Horse Whisperer. And I was like, right, well, now I have to find it. And I ended up just reading the whole thing. love a bit of Judy Blume. Love a Goosebumps. Grown up, loved a Goosebumps.
Oh yeah, Goosebumps were good.
Yeah. Goosebumps did Choose Your Own Adventure books, but that were great.
Other horror anthology series are available.
And I love a bit of Jane Austen. Oh, I love, genuinely, Pride and Prejudice.
I've period things do nothing for me. I can't go back beyond a certain amount of time.
Like, I don't really like historical fiction, but I like fiction that was written of the time of its history. Do you know what I mean? Like, Pride and Prejudice isn't historical fiction. It's just of its time.
I just don't like that either. I don't know.
It is an acknowledged fact that a single man with a fortune is in want of a wife. First line, Pride and Prejudice. Love it. Love that bit in the programme where he flexes his horn. Have you ever seen that?
No. What?
See, right, so...
Like hand muscles?
Women go mad for Pride and Prejudice because Mr. Darcy, who...
Colin Firth one?
No, the other one with Keira Knightley.
Who plays Mr. Darcy?
He's in that thing with the rich people. That programme that everybody liked with the rich people.
Downton Abbey?
No, the modern one where it's like set in America and Macaulay Culkin's brother's in it and everybody loved it.
Oh, right, Succession.
Yes, that guy. The big, tall English guy. He's in that. Anyway.
We'll find out.
He's Mr. Darcy, right? Mm-hmm. And he helps Elizabeth Bennet up into the carriage and takes her hand. And then as he walks away, he does this thing where he like flexes his fingers and then cuddles them back up again. And women literally went wild for it. Just this thing where he just...
A thing with these fingers? I mean, I've just done it there.
Stop it. This is a workplace ball. Get in touch via text 80295. Let us know your favourite book. Let us know what books you think translated well to film and which books you think absolutely did not translate well to film. We will hear about your worst cinematic interpretations of a book. Is there any that you think stand out as incredibly
bad?
John
Carter from Mars, which was a big... You know, that was the guy who wrote Tarzan Burroughs, and he did John Carter from Mars, who was essentially just Tarzan.
Yes.
And Mars. And the films were terrible.
But the books were good?
I thought, well, they were famous.
But have you read them?
No.
For me, the Harry Potter books to films, hashtag not any of mine.
They made $1 billion.
I, fair enough. Enjoy them. But to me, I could not stand them.
But it's the Nimbus 3000.
It's the Nimbus 2000. It's the fastest broom yet. Everybody... Paul, Hogwarts is a state school. Why does everybody talk like they're in Eton? Hashtag class.
Is it a state school?
Nobody's playing. Are you paying fees? Is Harry Potter paying fees for Hogwarts? No, he is not. Nobody's paying fees for Hogwarts.
I don't think they
have. Hogwarts is owned by nobody.
Well, they get free school dinners.
It's a state school. Yet somehow every single witch and wizard talks like this. Oh my goodness, Harry, have you learned to play Quidditch? Weird, eh? Weird.
The Weasleys don't.
The Weasleys are like, oh, we're poor. And then you go to their house, four stories in a garden. What do you mean you're poor? You've got your own bedroom.
They've also, their dad was a civil servant. He was making decent.
His dad was a civil servant and the son of a black who are like the most rich family in the wizarding world.
I've gone too thick
into the lore. I don't want to talk about it. Right, we're talking books, and as we're talking books, here's The Beatles with Paperback Writer. Hey.